The market's down, what, 250 points on the Sensex. The Nifty's down 93 points, almost to the day's low. Numbers have been coming through. Sadbhav Engineering reported third quarter earnings. And we've got Nitin Patel, executive director of the company, to talk about the numbers at this point in time. We got essentially profits which were down about 9%, and I'm told that's essentially a result of a sharp increase in tax outgo. Nitin, thanks for joining in. Prashant here. Could we start there? What happened with the tax outflow in the quarter?
See, actually, because of the ADIA exemption, which was earlier available for certain projects, which we have started before 1st of April 2017. So that basically are getting completed. And also the new projects which we have started later on, that definitely ADIA exemption is not available. So this is the main reason for the basically the effect of the tax for the quarter.
So what should be the tax rate going forward? Or for a company-wide basis? Once this exemption is phased through. Yes, sorry, go on.
Sure. See, eventually we will be continue to pay the MAT, minimum alternate tax, going forward. However, we had an unclaimed ATIA benefit where we will come into the full tax regime of around 185 crore. So this will help us to basically reduce the tax liability for the FY20 and the FY21.
Nitin, there was some amount of execution slowdown which took place in the quarter?
No, actually, all the projects which we have already taken up, these are well within the track. Only the projects which have not yet started, because three of the projects, what we were expecting that we should get an appointed date in the quarter. So definitely, this will shift to the Q1 of FY20 because of the certain land acquisition related issues. So once it is through, we will be able to take up the appointed date and start the execution.
How many of your projects are currently getting delayed because of various issues?
No. Under execution projects, we don't see any other problem. Hmm. The projects we are yet to take the appointed date. Okay. So there are the three of the projects under hybrid annuity mode, where basically the 80% of the lands are not yet through. We will take the appointed date once the basically all the lands and other approvals of forest and environmental issues will be there in the place.
So will Jan to March, the fourth quarter, has it already seen a very large ramp up in execution as compared to the third quarter?
See, on an average, our basically the expect and our guidance to the market that the around 3,800 crore of the top line we will be able to cross what we have guided. So that we are confident that we will be able to make it once we complete the execution of Q4. So that is the pace we will be seeing for the coming quarter.
What top line, sir? What's the number?
See, almost around, we are seeing almost around 9 to 11% jump over the Q4 of the last year's turnover. So almost closer to about 1200 crore we are eyeing basically for the quarter.
What is your order inflow guidance for FY19 stood at around 7 to 8000 odd crores. Does that still stand? What kind of order inflow guidance are you targeting now going to complete the year with?
See, obviously, considering all the basically bids we won for the current year as well as the past year, so we are expecting another 2,000 to 2,500 crore of the new business for the period is obviously less. I think within a month's time, the bidding process will be closed. And then after the bidding will start post the election. So as of now, NHAI is also basically geared up for a large number of bids. So we are basically eyeing certain bids basically within the coming 15 to 20 days.
Oh, okay. And the total incremental order inflow you're expecting is 2 to 2,500 odd crores. That's what you said.
That is what expectation we are basically trying and the way we are preparing our bids as of now.
Okay. And what is your total consolidated order book? Where does it stand?
See, currently we are sitting on almost closer to 13,000 crore of the order book. And what we see that considering the way the construction pace is there, so we have a clear visibility of 2.5 to 3 years from now. And obviously, the new orders, what will come, that will take the basically as a further guidance.
What is your plan in terms of asset monetization? Because I think that is one of the most important triggers that the street would be looking for. So you did have plans in terms of maybe 11 of your BOT projects. You might sell some amount of stake. What is the market looking like, and are you furthering your plans on it?
See, obviously, see, we are on a track related to our plans, actually. So, but obviously, as and when, as per the listing requirement, the time will come to make the announcement. So, we will come forward. But we are completely on a track so far as these plans are concerned.
Okay. All right, Nitin, we're going to leave it on that note. Thanks very much for joining in and speaking with us. So that's the view coming in from Sadbhav Engineering. They're expecting at least around 2,000 to 2,500 crores in terms of maybe incremental order inflow in FY19. Let's get a technical check-in. We have Ashwini Gujral joining in to talk about that at 11:30 a.m. Ashwini, over to you. Your market call as well as maybe stocks in today's trade.
See, basically, you know, below 10,680, 10,700, there's been, you know, more aggressive selling. So, it's likely that you are having a bit of a breakdown below 10,680 and, you know, the usual 10,600, 650 may or may not hold. So, that way, you know, you use these rallies to sell into. And use a stop about 10,700. My sense is that today you're having a bit of a trend day, and post noon you'll again have selling resume. So that way, you know, it's a narrow range is probably looking for reasons to break down. Now, having said that, Tech Mahindra is a sell with a stop of 790, target of 765. Hindalco is a sell with a stop of 191, target of 180. And Aarti Industries a buy with a stop of 1460, target of 1520.
Okay, well, we have a Twitter query. We have a viewer who has bought 200 shares of Nalco at 65. Should the viewer hold or sell? A.M. Kambati.
You know, the issue is that it's not even the best metal stock, and you know, trading below 200, all metal stocks are coming off. You basically have to, you know, buy these things at a significant bottom. A significant bottom on Nalco is 30-32. I don't think metals are quite showing you you know, upside traction. Maybe if people have to buy something, stay with large cap FMCG or large banks or large, you know, tech stocks, etc. You know, things like Nalco, etc., I don't think are going to outperform in the near future. And, you know, a 50 rupee, 40 rupee stock can easily fall down to 30, 32. So mid caps are really outperforming. So if you want to protect capital, at least move to the large caps.
Ashwini, this dip we are seeing in Yes Bank, would you do you already have a trade going, a call going?
See, we had bought yesterday, and you know, again, there will be a bit of consolidation, but this would now be a buy on decline type of stock. Maybe around 205 would be good levels to get into Yes Bank, but you have to get used to the gyrations. And on declines, definitely this is a buy.
Okay.